most common characteristic of all the world's great religions is the idea or the understanding that there's something about the heart that's more than a pump, that it's the access point to, you know, wisdom, you know, our spiritual side of ourselves. And, you know, some of the spiritual traditions call it the spiritual heart, to distinguish between the physical heart and the spiritual heart. We call it the energetic heart.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not coming from a religious perspective, just saying that the idea of the heart being a literal, not metaphysical, access point to our higher wisdom and self and capacities, love, compassion, has been around for thousands of years.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just coming along and doing research that actually is, you know, hardcore, rigorous, hard science,
right?
Laboratory-based studies that are actually strongly suggesting, if I may, that they've been right all along. So yes, there's the physical heart, and of course we, you know, it's the first organ to form in the fetus, and kind of marks the beginning and the end of life, and you know, but and it's certainly a very sophisticated blood regulation system, right? It's maybe probably not actually a pump, as it turns out, but the way it works, but. But okay, we can call it a pump, and it certainly has that function. But then what we're suggesting here at HeartMath is that the energetic heart is a very real thing with real structure. It's just something we can't put under a microscope yet. Like you can't put a thought or a feeling or, you know, an intuition under a microscope. Mm-hmm. We can look at physiological correlations to their activity. But so anyway, that the energetic heart is a real thing, and that when we're in a what we call more heart-coherent state, which is, again, a very measurable thing, that increases access to that part of who we really are, you know, our larger self at the vibrational level. And so when we learn to open that channel, it's what people mean when they say open the heart, is that we're really increasing the communication pathway from who we, you know, that larger part of ourself, our vibrational self, our energetic self, which is translated down through the energetic heart, down to the DNA, mind-brain systems. And that is literally, from my perspective, what elevates consciousness.